Hi guys, this is Erwin from 2devilsindicators.com, and today I want to take another look at our bar replay indicator. Now, most of you probably know we already did a video about this a couple of days ago, I guess. But we received a lot of feedback from you guys, and because of that, we added some new stuff, some new features you requested, and in this video, I want to go over them and show you all the features again. But before that, like always, just a quick reminder, you can find us at 2devilsindicators.com, and over there you can find all our indicators and products, including this one. We also have a free trial for if you want to test out any of our indicators, then make sure to use it. It does not cost you anything. You get a 7-day free trial. And after 7 days, you can decide if you want to buy or lease it or not. So that's pretty awesome. And we also have a Discord. So if you have any questions or you want to talk with me and other traders, then feel free to join. We'd love to see you inside. And with that said, let's go to the bar replay indicator. Now, any one of you who have done some backtesting in NinjaTrader probably heard about the market replay feature. NinjaTrader has a market replay feature built in, but most of you who have ever used it will agree that it's terrible. It's not user friendly, it's slow, and it makes backtesting horrible. So most people who tried it just give up because it's not really usable, in my opinion. And that's why we came up with the bar replay indicator. The bar replay indicator allows you to backtest your strategies quick and with ease. And in this video, I'm going to show you how it works. So now on the chart, you can see I have NinjaTrader open, simple Renko bar. Just to have something to look at, I added our TMA bands. And TMA bands gives clear buy and sell signals. And we can use that, for example, to do some testing with our bar replay indicator. So let's add it to the chart. So I'm going to TDU, select the bar replay indicator. And you will notice that when I now press OK, that this scroll bar goes all the way to the left. And that we only see the first couple of bars. And this is what you see then. So notice now the scroll bar is all the way to the left. We only see the first couple of bars, and everything to the right here is hidden. So we don't see what's going to happen in the future. We only see what's happening in the past. And we see a trade panel or a panel over here, says no trade yet. We have a drop-down menu where you can change some of the settings. And we have the order panel on the bottom. And let's go over all these things. So first things first, let's focus on these four buttons. Those are pretty simple. If you press the button to the right, you can see we have get another bar. If you press the button to the left, then it goes back one bar, and that way you can quickly go to the next or previous bar. Then we have the fast forward and the fast forward and the fast backwards. Those will advance 10 bars to the right or to back to the left. And of course you can say how many bars you want to advance. So by default it's 10, but you can change this number to anything you like. So these four buttons allow us to advance in time and go back in time. And we also have the go to button, which we will use later on, which allows you to quickly go to a specific time, which is very handy because I only trade the regular trading hours. So if I want to test, I just want to go to the 9:30, which is my time the session opens, and trade from there. I'm not interested in the overnight. So those are these buttons. And then we have basically the order panel buttons. We have two buys and two sells. And the difference is, let's see, move a couple of bars forward. Okay, so the buy close will open a trade at the close of this bar. So if I press buy close, you can see it over here. It's now one tick above this close. And you can, of course, change that in the indicator settings. Here you can see the buy, sell, close offset in ticks. So it's set to 1. So if I press buy close, it opens a trade 1 tick above the close. And if you then move forward to the next bar, you will see that the trade gets opened. And the stop loss and the take profits levels are set. Those settings you can also change. You have the initial stop loss and the initial target. So let's move this, for example, to 25. And the stop loss maybe to 18. Okay. And of course, you can move those around, right? It's just like you are used to in NinjaTrader. You can put them and place them anywhere you like. And when the trade is opened, you also get these numbers, which show you how far you are in profit, both in dollars and in ticks, the risk reward, number of contracts, and you can see your stop loss as well. So if you move forward, then well, you can see that we're now $87 in profit. And now we get a reversal bar, and then you are in a loss. You can close the trade by just pressing close, and then it's closed again. So that's basically the buy, a little bit further, so we have some more clear space. The buy close, we also have a buy chart, and the buy chart allows you to open a buy trade wherever you want. So let's say I want to open a trade here, and I move forward, and if price ever gets there, then it will open the trade. Oh, this was maybe a little bit too quick. Let's open another one, maybe right here, and move it step by step. And you will see that if price ever comes there, then it will open the trade, right? And the sell chart and the sell close are just the opposite. So if I press sell close, it will open a sell 1 tick below the previous bar. So here you have a down bar. I press sell close, and it's 1 tick below the close. And if I press next, it will open a sell trade. So this allows you to quickly open and close trades. Of course, you can open multiple trades. So we now have one, but I can add another one if I want to. Now, for example, I added another one. I have 2 now. And of course, you can move the targets and stop losses of each trade individually if you want. And you can also change the number of contracts you would like to change. Now, after you opened one or more trades, you will see this panel appearing. And the panel just shows you the statistics of all your trades. So now, in this smart period, we did 5 trades. You can see the average trade per day, your profit, your win ratio, blah, 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 all the things you would like to know if you are doing backtesting. So now that we have explained the buttons and features, let's just quickly see how this would work when you do some real testing. So I'm going to reset the chart. You can do this by F5 or reload NinjaScript. Then it goes back to the beginning. Sorry. And then I'm just going to go to the 9:30, which is the open of the session. And there it is. Here you have the session open. And we're just going to trade some of those signals and see how it performs. So here we already have the first signal. It's a sell signal. So I want to sell 1 tick below the bar. So I press sell close. And then it's just a matter of going forward and seeing how things would work. Well, that's the winner. Then here we have a buy signal, so let's take that one. You get a reversal bar, so I'm going to close it. Another buy signal, so I'm going to buy it. Reversal signal, so I'm going to close it. So 1 winner, 2 losers. Another buy signal. And that's a winner. And you can already see that it's now 9:47, so we are 17 minutes into the session. We made 4 trades and we made $500 with a profit factor of 5. Now, of course, trades is not enough to get real insights into how good this strategy is. So let's continue, because we'll probably get some losers as well. Sell trades, sell close. And it's going against us, so I'm going to close this for a little loss. And that's what you typically will see, by the way, with these TMA bands, that the runners can be very big, but the losers will be very, very small. Buy, so let's open it, and it's immediately reversing, so small loser. Oh. Let's buy this one, and it's also a loser. Let's buy this one. Also scratch, and we have another sell. So let's, for example, see how far this goes. Again, it's going against us. We're not very lucky at the moment, but it's no problem. We just keep on backtesting. Till we hit the end of the session. So we have a buy. Again. Buy. And again. Sell. Finally, we have a winner, about time, and a buy. Okay, and let's see if we can add on to this trade. I have no idea what's going to happen. Maybe it's going to reverse, maybe not, but I would like to add to this trade. So I'm going to buy again, just to show you that it's possible. So if it's going to close higher, which it is, then I'm going to close it around here. So let's... First one is hit, and move the target higher, and let's move the stop loss, for example, to around here. And we're just going to see how far we can get it. So that was a nice trade. Then we get a sell again. So let's do a sell, and we are almost at 12 o'clock. Maybe we want to do another sell, so close, move stop loss to break even, so we're not losing anything. First one is hit, and it's again Twill, for example, this one, move stop loss to break even. Just going to ride this as long as we can. There we have a... reversal, so let's close it right here. Okay, and that's how you can add to existing trades if you want to. Again, we have a buy. Let's see how far it goes. This is looking good, 19 ticks, so I want to buy again. First one gets hit, and the second one gets stopped out. Okay. And of course it goes to the moon. It always happens right then, like that, right? Sell, and we are now 2 o'clock. It stopped out. Okay, shit happens. And we have a buy. Target, and we have a sell. That one goes to target. Well, let's just continue. We're almost at the end of the session. Yep, another sell, which is... That one got stopped out. Buy here. That would be probably around the last time I would trade 1540. So you can see that in a matter of minutes, we tested an entire session. We took all the trades. We showed how you can add to trades. And if you just go back, you can see all those trades. And if you now look at the results of this one session, 22 trades, we made $1,950 of profit. Profit factor was 2, and our win ratio was 47%. So overall, pretty good. I hope you can see that I didn't use any hindsight trading, and I just took those buys and sell signals and added on to trades I was thinking, well, these could be potentially go. And that's basically how you can easily backtest any strategy, not just these DMA bands. Now, suppose that you want to continue backtesting tomorrow. Well, that's very simple to do. What you can do is you can go to the menu and choose save your trades. So save trades to disk. Save it, okay. And notice we have 23 trades. So if I now refresh by pressing F5 or choosing Reload Ninja script, and let's suppose it's another day, I can just go back, load trades, and it's okay, and it loaded 23 days, and I can just continue where I was. So here you can see all the trades we done, and this is where we stopped. So now we can just continue where we left without us needing to start all over again, which is very handy, because I usually backtest one or two sessions, and then when I'm done, I'm saving it and going continuing the next day. So if this is the next day, then you can see we stopped at 1540, so I want to go to the next session. I press go to, it goes to the next open, and now you can just start backtesting the next session and the next day. For example, again, not a buy chart. I wanted to buy close and see if that happens. So, this is basically how it works. Let's go quickly over the settings. Most of them we already show. You can see all those show things. Those are just if you want to show the numbers on the chart, like the profit in dollars or ticks, the risk to reward, the contracts, you can turn them on and off. Stop loss. Some people like to see those, some don't. I do like it. Some people would like to turn those off. The statistics channel, which is this part, you can choose where you want to show that. These are the coordinates. Then we have the order panel down here, if you want to show it on the bottom, the top, the left, or the right. And some of these settings like the stop loss and targets. The commissions per trade you need to pay. I put them at 0, but if you put something in there, then it will account for the commissions you have to pay. We already spoke about the the fast forward step size, the close ticks offsets, and the session start time. You can see here. And the last setting is the chart offset, which is this one. And that's just when you open a trade. Well, let's open a sell, for example. Sell close. And then it's just how wide these lines are. At the moment, the width of these lines is 15% of the entire chart. But you can make them wider or you can make them smaller, whatever you you prefer. And now I'm curious if this is a win or not. It is. That's basically the bar replay indicator. And I hope you can see that it's very easy to backtest your strategies. You can save and load your trades to continue another day. You can see them on the chart. You can see all the statistics. I hope you can see that you're not trading with hindsight, because you don't know what's going to happen over here. You can only see the current candle and the previous candles. So that's That's about, I guess, the bar replay indicator. There is one thing which we cannot fix at the moment, and that's if you have indicators below the chart. So I want to make this very clear. For example, if you have a, let's say you have a MACD. Right. Let's say you have a MACD below the chart. Then you will see that we cannot hide what's below the chart, and that's the how do you say it? Something which NinjaTrader does not allow us to do. So if you are using indicators below the chart, you will need to hide them yourself. And how can you do that? Well, you can, for example, draw a rectangle. Let's see, where can I find a rectangle? And I know this is a little bit cumbersome, but yeah, it's the only way at the moment. We're still looking into see if this if you can fix it, but yeah, it seems to be a limitation of NinjaTrader. So I'm making this black with an opacity of 100. Okay, and now you can see that okay, this allows me to at least hide stuff on the chart, and of course you need to align it with the current price. So yeah, it's a bit cumbersome, but it does work. But it's yeah, it's not really what you would like, of course. I can imagine, but yeah, it's a limitation, and we spend a lot of time trying to hide this as well. But so far, no luck. Maybe we can fix that in the future. We will have to discuss it with NinjaTrader itself, I guess, if that's possible. But just know there is that limitation. Anything on the chart is not a problem. That works just fine. And with that, I guess that's the all I had to say for this video. Again, if you would like to test it, you can just go to our indicator, to our website, go to indicators. It's somewhere around here, bar replay. Looking forward to then. Bar replay, there it is, the bar replay indicator. We do have this 7-day free trial if you want to test it. And of course, you can either buy it or you can lease it if you want a subscription based. And you can also read some more details on this page if you want to something more. Yeah, and if you have questions, feel free to join the Discord, so you can talk with me and other traders. Okay, guys, that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave your comments below, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.